Hello. Last time we have seen about the composition of two SHMs. The first case here is the two SHMs have the same frequency and these SHMs are acting along the same line. Now we have seen these SHMs are to be described by the equations x1 is equal to a1 sine omega t plus alpha 1 and x2 is equal to a2 sine omega t plus alpha 2. Now these two SHMs are along the same line. Their amplitudes are different. Their frequency is same and initial phases are to be different here. Now according to superposition principle, we have seen that the resultant motion or resultant displacement is given by x is equal to x1 plus x2. And finally, we get the expression here, x is equal to r sine omega t plus phi. X is equal to r sine omega t plus phi. Here, this is also the simple harmonic motion. R represents the amplitude of the resultant SHM. That we have seen the value of R last time. R is equal to under root of A1 square plus A2 square plus twice A1 A2 cos alpha 1 minus alpha 2. That is, we have seen here the resultant amplitude R is depends on the value of phase difference, that is alpha 1 minus alpha 2. Now we can determine the value of phi then. We have the equations A1 cos alpha 1 plus A2 cos alpha 2 is equal to R cos phi. We have considered in that case the equation number 4, I think. And another equation that we have here, A1 sine alpha 1 plus A2 sine alpha 2 is equal to R sine delta, R sine phi here. Equation number 5. Dividing equation 5 by 4, that we write here, dividing equation 5 by 4, that is R sine phi upon R cos phi is equal to A1 sine alpha 1 plus A2 sine alpha 2 divided by A1 cos alpha 1 plus A2 cos alpha 2. R get cancel here. Sin phi upon cos phi is tan phi. That we write here, tan phi is equal to A1 sin alpha 1 plus A2 sin alpha 2 upon A1 cos alpha 1 plus A2 cos alpha 2. And therefore, finally, we can find out the value of phi as phi is equal to tan inverse. Phi is equal to tan inverse A1 sine alpha 1 plus A2 sine alpha 2 upon A1 cos alpha 1 plus A2 cos alpha 2 here. And in this way, you can determine the value of initial phase of the resultant motion. And here, there is amplitude of the resultant motion that we have obtained here. Now let us see about the composition of two SHMs. These two SHMs also have the same frequency, but they are perpendicular to each other. That is, one is along the x-axis and another one is along the y-axis. That is, we can represent them as these two SHMs are to be described here as x is equal to a sine omega t plus alpha. x is equal to a sin omega t plus alpha. Suppose this is our equation number 1, and we can consider another one, y is equal to b sin omega t. This is equation number 2. These two SHMs are perpendicular to each other. One is along the x-axis and another one is along the y-axis here. Their amplitudes are different. Their frequency is same, that we can see omega and omega. And the phase difference here is alpha, that we can see here. Now we can write equation number 2. Equation number 2 can be written as y upon b is equal to sine omega t. Y upon b is equal to sine omega t here. We know that sine square omega t plus cos square omega t is equal to 1. And therefore, we can write here cos square omega t is equal to 1 minus sine square omega t. And that is equal to 1 minus sine omega t is y upon b. And therefore, sine square omega t can be written here as y square upon b square. Or we write here cos omega t. For our convenience, we can write here cos omega t is equal to under root of 1 minus y square upon b square. We get the value of cos omega t here. हि वैल्यू आपल्याला नंतर पुट अप करण्यासाठी यूज करता येईल. दॅट्स व्हाय वी कॅन राइट हियर दिस रिलेशन cos omega t is equal to under root of 1 minus y square upon b square. Now let us consider again equation number 1. This equation number 1 can be written as x upon a. A can be shifted to the left side here, is equal to, on the right hand side, what we have left, sine of omega t plus alpha. Sine of omega t plus alpha. We know sine A plus B. Sine A plus B is sine A cos B plus cos A sine B. And therefore, we can write here it is equal to sine of omega t t cos alpha plus cos of omega t into sin alpha here. That is equal to sin omega t is y upon b. That is from this equation that we write here y upon b into cos alpha. Plus cos omega t is under root of 1 minus y square upon b square into sin alpha here, into sin alpha. Now further we can write it as x upon a, this term is shifted to the left side, it becomes minus. That is minus y upon b cos alpha is equal to under root of 1 minus y square upon b square into sine alpha. Suppose this is our equation number 3. Now we can square this equation number 3. Here we can consider a minus b. X upon a minus y upon b cos alpha. We have to take the square of this value. And that's why we can write here x square upon a square plus, let us see, y square upon b square cos square alpha. Y square upon b square cos square alpha minus 2xy upon ab cos alpha. 2xy upon ab cos alpha. upon a into cos alpha is equal to, on the right hand side this square can be removed, sorry, this root sign can be removed then by squaring it, and that's why on the right hand side we can write 1 minus y square upon b square into sine square alpha. We can solve this bracket then, that we write here sine square alpha minus y square upon b square into sine square alpha. Now this term now shifted to the left hand side, and then we can write here x square upon a square plus y square upon b square into cos square alpha, ये term अपन left लगेंगे, plus y square upon b square into sin square alpha minus 2xy upon ab cos alpha is equal to sin square alpha. Now then here y square upon b square can be taken as a common factor, and then we get here x square upon a square plus y square upon b square in bracket cos square alpha plus sin square alpha minus 2xy upon ab cos alpha is equal to sin square alpha. Now then, your cos square alpha plus sin square alpha is equal to, that is to be equal to 1. And therefore, finally, we get here x square upon a square plus y square upon b square minus 2xy upon ab cos alpha is equal to sin square alpha. Now here this is the equation of resultant motion. Now this is the equation of general ellipse. This is the equation of the general ellipse. Suppose this is our equation number 4, we can call it as. Now here the resultant motion will depends on the value of alpha. That is, some cases may arise here from the value of alpha here. Depending on the alpha, we get the number of cases here. Now let us see here, when alpha is equal to 0, when alpha is equal to 0, that we write here x square upon a square plus y square upon b square minus 2xy upon ab into cos alpha means 0. Cos 0 is equal to sin square 0. Cos 0 is 1 and sin square 0 is equal to 0 here, and that's why here we get x square upon a square plus y square upon b square minus 2xy upon ab is equal to 0. That is equal to 0. And this equation can be written as x upon a minus y upon b bracket square is equal to 0. Or we write here x upon a minus y upon b is equal to 0. Or we write y upon b is equal to x upon a. And therefore y is equal to b upon a into a. Here b and a are constant. Now this is the equation of the type y is equal to mx. y is equal to mx plus c, where c is zero in constant. M is the slope here, and this is the equation of straight line having the slope m. Now here we get the nature of the resultant motion is the straight line here, and its slope is b upon a. Its slope is b upon a here. It represents the straight line. Now we consider another case then, when alpha is equal to pi. Now in that case, what we get here? Suppose here we can put x square upon a square plus y square upon b square minus 2xy upon ab cos pi. Cos pi is minus 1. And therefore that minus and minus, here it will become plus, is equal to sine pi is again 0. That is equal to 0. And therefore here we get x upon a plus y upon b bracket square is equal to 0. This equation can be written in this form here. Or we write x upon a plus y upon b is equal to 0. Or we write here y upon b is equal to x upon b. And therefore, again, here it is minus. Y is equal to minus b upon a into x. Again, here this equation represents a straight line, but its slope is minus b upon a. Its slope is minus b upon a here. Thank you. Left of the case that we can explain later on. Thank you very much.